So the CNC machine has become a little bit of a dumping ground for me. I'm having a moment of crisis where I'm actually starting to want to use the lathe, which is a very weird feeling. And I've actually dismounted my router, which is quite frustrating. And I'll talk about that in a second. To build, start building this cabinet, which I'll then move the lathe onto. I was working quite hard to kind of get the CNC machine up to scratch, and it was a very interesting process. And I decided to use my router with this machine. But the problem I'm having is the collets are really expensive, and just little things like the difference between a quarter inch and a 6 mil collet. It's just causing me a little bit of trouble. I mean, I've got a bit of a bone to pick with this particular router because it seems like everywhere in the world there are slight variations of it. So in the States, you can get a version which has a variable speed, but you can't get that in the UK or in Europe, it seems. Because this router doesn't have a variable speed, it literally goes like a rocket the second you turn it on at 33,000 RPM, and that's just too much. If you look at spindles that are available for CNC machines, they on average go up to 24,000, and that's all you need. That means they're quieter, they run cooler. This is a little bit overkill, I think, at that speed. I'm planning to build a control box with a lot of the stuff that I bought, and I'm going to be following Martin Balfour's plans, and I'll provide a link to those in the description. I think his videos are very interesting and very in depth, especially for someone like me who's a bit of a novice with respect to CNC. I'm kind of learning as I go along. I'm not sure if I'm going to wait until I get a new spindle or if I will use this thing here, but I'd like to recut these end plates so they're much taller, and then I'll change the C-beam linear actuator around so the piece here will be actually on the back and I'll have the full movement of the beam. And the spindle will go on that. I mean, we're all kind of aware that the extraction on normal routers blows the dust all over the place. And a few times that I have used this, it, even despite having a hood that I do use, sometimes my bits are not long enough to do the cutting with the hood on, and I have to take it off. And it does feel like a lot of dust does kick up in the air. So another kind of idea I've had is possibly to build a housing for this, which can just contain a lot of the dust and noise. So I've got a few things that I need to work on. Probably the first thing I should do is just tidy up. The other thing to mention is I finally got some software with which to generate G-code. I'll be using ArtCam Express, which seems a little similar to VCarve. It's a CAD and CAM software, so that means I'll have to send the G-code to the machine via the Universal G-code sender. This is the software I'm most familiar with because I use it at work, and I got a license for the basic version through my SNARF development. That means I can consolidate my knowledge instead of potentially having to learn something new, and anything I do learn will support the students I work with. There's a lot of features and options to control your cutting with this software which are not available with something like Easel. You can select where to place tabs, you have ramping, lead in and out, and so on. It does feel like CNC is a little bit of a bottomless hole when it comes to how much things cost, and I know a lot of people can't afford this type of software. There are alternatives, and you could use something like Sketchercam or Chili Pepper if you want a bit more control over your G-code. I'm going to try and aim to produce a video every month on this channel just because of the investment of time and money this technology demands. Do let me know if there's anything you want me to try and do with my machine, and please check out Martin's channel, which I mentioned earlier. Thanks again for watching, and see you next time. Although I won't be seeing you, you'll be seeing me.